Hey everyone, in this video, we're going to be coding the Simpson's one-third rule in Python. Let's briefly recall what the Simpson's one-third rule is first. The Simpson's one-third rule is a numerical method that allows us to approximate a definite integral. In this numerical integration technique, we fit quadratics to our data and sum together the area underneath, and that allows us to approximate the definite integral. This schematic here should make this more clear. I'm going to be coding this in PyCharm, which is a free, downloadable, integrated design environment. Let's begin by creating a new file. Then, we will need to import our relevant Python libraries. As we are going to both be approximating the definite integral and graphing our function, we're going to need three Python libraries. We're going to be using NumPy, SciPy, and Matplotlib. Let's come to our interpreter in the bottom right here. As you can see, it says Simpson's 1-3 rule, as that is what we created initially. Let's click this and hit Interpreter Settings. This is very important, as if you have the wrong interpreter selected, Python won't recognize the packages we are about to download. You can change your interpreter up at the top here. Once you have the right interpreter selected, let's click on the small plus sign down here. We will then search for NumPy, select it, and click Install Package. Then we'll repeat the same thing for Matplotlib and SciPy. Now that all of our relevant Python packages are installed, let's close this window. We now need to import the packages. So, let's type in import numpy as mp, import matplotlib.pyplot as plt, and then lastly, we say from scipy interpolate import this, as this is all we need from the scipy library. Next, we are going to create two function definitions. One for the function that we are approximating the definite integral for, and another optional function for our fourth derivative if you wish to find the maximum error. Both of these functions will take in some value x and return the result of our function. Let's now list out some of our required function parameters. We have our lower integration bound, a, our upper integration bound, b, our number of equally spaced subintervals, n, and then let's initialize an iteration variable, j, that we will use shortly. Then let's make this formula to find our step size, dx. This is simply our total integrating distance over our number of subintervals. Next, we are going to create two variables, x and y. Imagine these as a table of our data points. This numpy linspace function for our x variable is simply saying, beginning at a, our lower integration bound, and ending at B, our upper integration bound, create n plus 1 equal data points. We need to use n plus 1 here, as our number of inputs needed is always going to be one more than our number of subsections. Using our newly created x and y variables, we can implement our Simpson's 1/3 rule now. We just have our step size over 1/3 times all of this here. These two middle terms may look a bit confusing, but they're just implementing the 4, 2, 4 repeating pattern that is present in the Simpson's 1/3 rule. Printing these terms alone and adding this table on the left, I hope it is more clear what is going on here. In the first term here, we are beginning at our first point, but do not include it. Then we advance 2 to 4.75, and then another 2 to 2.25. Then we reach our endpoint of n, but again, we do not include it. Then, in the actual Simpson's 1/3 rule here, these get added together using the sum function. Next, let's add in a way of calculating the maximum error of our Simpson's 1/3 rule. This section will be finding the maximum fourth derivative of our function. Then it will be plugged into the following formula. Our 1D matrix of x4 prime here is just saying that within the bounds of a to b, create an arbitrary amount of inputs. I just put n times 100. The more points created here, the more accurate your answer will be, with the trade-off of slightly longer program runtimes. As a note, with any third-order polynomial, our Simpson's one-third rule can find the exact solution, meaning that we should expect to see zero error, which we do. At this point, we're essentially done with finding Simpson's one-third rule and the associated maximum error. I'm just going to add a small fprint statement that returns our results found. Now that we have completed finding Simpson's one-third rule, let's begin working on graphing our solution as well. I will begin by creating the function that we are solving for. Then, I will just add this to our matplotlib plot, like so. In running our program, you can see our plotted polynomial, but this isn't all we want. So, let's create a while loop that says while j, our iterating variable from earlier, is in the range of our number of intervals, do the following. It will select our first and third data points, and create 25 equal subsections between them. Then, using SciPy's interpolation function, we'll fit a 1D quadratic. I will leave a link in the description of this video that describes how to use this SciPy function in more detail. Then, we are going to add this 3-point quadratic to our matplotlib graph. Then, optionally, I'm going to add a line that will fill in underneath our quadratic as we are approximating integrals. This alpha argument is basically just the opacity of our fill. Then, we need to iterate our j variable by 2. Now, running our program, we can get a great visualization of how Simpson's one-third rule actually works and the quadratics that are used in approximating it. Additionally, if you want to visualize more of the function on your matplotlib graph, we can simply adjust our lower and upper bounds on this bit of code here. And there we go. We have now just coded a cool Simpson's one-third rule Python code that can approximate a definite integral using Simpson's one-third rule. We can then find the Simpson's one-third rule maximum error and provide a handy graph to visualize the function. I hope that this video helped your understanding of how to code Simpson's one-third rule in Python. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking that join button down below. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.